the universe, especially as exemplified by the night sky, it's beautiful beyond words.
I think people are just naturally curious about the world around them. I think it's in our nature.
We are literally living in a mote of dust in the universe, but we are very special creatures because so far, we are the only living beings in the universe. I never fail to stop and just look up to see what's up there. It's been something that I've always marveled at my whole life. I grew up out in the country, far away from city lights, about 30 miles west of Indianapolis. And we had a big farmhouse, and every night on a clear night, I'd go climb up on the roof, and I would have a horizon to horizon view of the night sky. And I just taught myself the basics, the constellations, which point of light was a planet, which one was a star, phases of the moon, that sort of thing. And that just got me hooked because we had such a crystal clear night sky. This is the 36-inch Link telescope. It was built by Dr. Link, Goethe Link, who was a surgeon at Indiana University. And back in the 1930s, he wanted to build his own observatory. He decided to build this observatory here. We're actually standing at the highest point in Morgan County. Back in the 30s, this was far away from the city lights of Indianapolis, which wasn't nearly as big as it is now. So it was a perfect spot for him to engage his passion. It was quite a venture. He paid for it himself, and he used it for his own personal use for about 10 years. And then in 1948, he donated it to Indiana University, and IU used it for education and research for about four decades. And then they retired it in the late 1980s. We offer open houses here at the observatory a couple times a month. We offer daytime and nighttime open houses. We open it up and let people tour around, and they learn the history of the facility and learn about Dr. Link and how he built it. And then at night, that's when the really good fireworks start, because especially on a clear night, we'll open up the shutters, fire up the scope, and we can look at all kinds of things. So we have public engagement events here at the telescope a couple times a month. And then we also do multimedia presentations throughout central Indiana and even the state. We can see craters on the moon that are this big around through the eyepiece. You can see mountains that are 15,000 feet high on the moon. We can see the Great Red Spot on Jupiter. We can see its four biggest moons, which are known as the Galilean moons. We can see the rings of Saturn. And when people see the rings of Saturn, that really gets them excited because it looks so real. They almost think it looks fake, like it looks like a picture, because they're just not used to how stark it is, seeing it with their own eyes. We can see galaxies 20 million light years away. These are galaxies far, far away that you ordinarily couldn't see through a pair of binoculars or a smaller scope, but through this telescope, you can see spiral bands. You can see the structure of galaxies all over the night sky. Once you look through this telescope, it is quite exciting. There's just nothing like it. When people come and see these objects for the first time, their passion is just ignited. A spark goes on, and that's what we're really looking for.
It's really cool how the stars can just like fascinate anyone, regardless of whether they're a professional astronomer or not. When I was in late elementary school, I stumbled across a show on the History Channel called The Universe, and I watched a whole bunch of episodes, and I was just like, wow, this is cool. And I was just transfixed by the things that I saw, that the beauty that you can see in the night sky. I was in a STEM mentorship program, 6th through 8th grade, where I was mentored by a local astronomy and physics professor. And then in high school, I further continued that by joining my high school science Olympiad team, and I was their go-to person for the astronomy event. And then because of that, through all that experience, I was just like, why not study in college?
Go to the left a little bit.
Last spring, I was approached by one of my professors, and he's just like, the president of Astronomy Club is, he's a senior, and like, obviously he's graduating, and we, as far as I know, like, he doesn't really have a replacement. Do you wanna be president of Astronomy Club? And I'm like, this is really cool. Like, it'll give me a chance to like, actually like, go to Astronomy Club and, you know, attend events and do more like hands-on stuff with my astronomical knowledge.
I've done it twice. I definitely would have said that.
You can observe with your naked eye. You can observe with a telescope, and there are lots of different kinds of telescopes. Like, I have probably like a $100 telescope back home. You could go to an observatory. You could even like going out to like a dark place, for example, like Lake Monroe. You can see some pretty good stars around there. With the naked eye, I really like seeing Orion. It's my favorite constellation. Jupiter can be really cool, even with like a small like amateur telescope.
You can see Galileo. Yeah, three of them.
Whenever I get the chance, even if I don't have a telescope with me, I like to just like stare up at the night sky and like observe the beauty that is up there. Like, I would be that kid who would be like so transfixed on the night sky as I'm walking that I would walk into something.
That's super crude astronomy right there.
The universe, and especially as exemplified by the night sky, is it's beautiful beyond words. So to get a chance to like stop and reflect and on what you see up above is a really cool thing to be able to do.
I think people are just naturally curious about the world around them, and I think it's in our nature.
The center of the nebula is hotter, and it thus makes it easier to excite that oxygen gas or the hydrogen gases.
I've always had an interest in space. I grew up during the Apollo program. When I was a little kid, you know, I built the rockets, built the models, followed all that. I remember in third grade, I had a notebook with all of the data I could find on all the planets. After I graduated from Rose-Hulman, I was able to go to grad school and actually work on the Viking space program, a program that went to Mars. I wanted to become a college professor from my days in high school, and when I got the opportunity to come here to work to Rose, it was just sort of like a dream come true for me. And then a few years after that, they asked me if I wanted to work on the observatory, and obviously I grabbed that opportunity as well. And I've been doing this for 27 years now.
It's actually the best I've ever seen Jupiter.
Up here in the Oakley Observatory, we have 8 permanently mounted telescopes. We have 2 6-inch refracting telescopes. We have 4 17-inch reflecting telescopes, and we have 2 20-inch reflecting telescopes. The reason we have all these telescopes instead of just one big one is really the essence of a Rose-Hulman education is hands-on experience. And so this way the students can come out and they can actually use the telescopes themselves rather than watch someone else do it.
We're going to be getting into imaging in lab, and you'll be making your own pictures like this.
We offer an area minor in astronomy, and we have an observational astronomy class that meets out here in the observatory. We also have a very active astronomy club, and they meet once a week. And we put on open houses for the public. We also have special events. The students are the things that drive my passion. They are really interested in astronomy, and it's a great opportunity to get them excited about things in the classroom and also out here in the observatory. There's just a lot of interest among the students for astronomy.
Look up whenever you get the chance. There's so much out there. If you just take the time to look up and be wondrous about it and be curious.
And if you think back to caveman days, and there was no light pollution, and there were no TV, and no internet, you're sitting by the campfire, and all you have to do is look up.
Looking up at the night sky just reminds you that we're not the center of the universe. There's a whole lot of other things out there that maybe we don't necessarily pay attention to. It's an awe-inducing, and it reminds me to be humble.